Hello everyone, I think you all are fine. So let's get started with a new video of how to prepare your resume. So we're gonna think that we're gonna place in a big tech companies, but due to our bad resumes and automated tracking systems that are tracked over there, cannot get selected our resume for the interview. So now this problem is very crucial, so I think the solution is the better resumes and the better format that we can discuss over there. So let's get started with this one. So my name is Yash Vastogi. This is my channel, Live Code Alone. So we are discussing today how to make a better resume for college placements and for job. So we're gonna discuss about these topics like summary, education, experience, personal skills, projects, technical skills, key course taken, certifications, and along with position of responsibilities and achievements that you have done in your school and colleges. Like positions and responsibilities, you think that the things that that I am the founder and president in my the college, so I can write that one, that I am the founder and president of Computer Society of Web Developers. If you are the part of any club and any society, you can write over there position and responsibilities, along with you can write over there like the student, if you are your class coordinator or any the team leading spirit that you have to follow in your past, that you can write over there. So methods or app by which you can make your resume better for jobs. So I have selected two of the most you can say standard tools that they make resumes the best ones for the non-technical background students. The one is the Canva, and for technical students the one is the Overleaf. Overleaf is a platform that use lattice language. You can learn lattice in just 2 to 3 minutes if you learn the basic of HTML. So for the BTech, BSc and BCA students that are taking degree in bachelor's of technology or science or applications, that can use Overleaf a well tool for the jobs that they are grabbing in the FANG companies or any of the big tech companies. And along with the students that are non-technical backgrounds, I have one more thing for you guys, that I have a Word file over there in my description box that you can go and download it, and along with you can you can add this PDF in your phone or in your laptop, so that's not hard to add a PDF or add a Word file in your phone or in your laptop. So for non-technical background students like BA, BCom, BA, BArch, BPharma, BDS and BBS students, we're gonna discuss about how to make the resume in the Canva, and for the technical students we're gonna discuss over the Overleaf. So along with, there are many websites that are freely available in online, like website like resumebuilder.com is my favorite one, that build resumes in just 5 to 4 minutes. And along with, some of the websites are also there, so you can go through in the web and check the resume building websites over there. I think the best method for resume making is in the Canva or in the Overleaf. Here you find the tons of resume formatting and resume guidance, because there are lots of templates available in these platforms, and you can choose the one template and edit in few seconds. So let's grab the opportunity of going to the big tech companies and let's move forward. So resume making by Canva follow these steps for ATS friendly resumes. The automatic tracking systems are there in the big tech companies that track your applications and along with remove you from the path of your interview. So we're gonna use simple formatting, simple formattings and use keywords and header and footers. I'm going to show you the exact things that you have to done in your resume. So for the better ATS friendly things, along with in this journey, I am showing you how to use the Canva and make your resumes, and the steps that I am talking about, the things, these are important and are standard guidance that has given in the ATS websites. Along with these are the favorite points that the HR checking in your resumes. So simple formatting, use clear heading like standard fonts and avoid graphics tables. Means you have to avoid the graphics and tables. Don't make tables and graphics. Just be clear what you are doing. Standard fonts, use standard fonts. Use keywords that match job terms, like job descriptions. You firstly read the job descriptions, then make your resume a bell one. Because if you write the job description, then you can make your changes in your resume according to the job description. That increase the possibility to grab the job easily. Along with no header or footer, place important info contact in the main body. Standard headings like work experience, skills, education. And there is one more thing, that is chronological format. Use reverse chronological format, means that in which organization did you are working on, write it first, then write anything else in later. Like if you are making this project recently, then write it in the first, then write your previous projects that you have made. Along with ATS friendly formats, like don't download your resumes in PPT or any other format, download in safe format like docs, simple PDF format. No special character, avoid fancy symbols, emojis or complex formatting. Avoid complex formatting, like you can write any name over there, ki I am doing that, no that. Just write simple things in your resume that are ATS friendly. Use action verbs like I have managed this project, I have developed this project. This make a sense to the interviewer that you have done in something in your past. Now let's move for the overleaf. Which are the steps that overleaf follow to make your resume to be selected in the top companies? These are the things, and these are the main core things you have to learn first. Then you have to make your resume. That's if you are making the resume, you can actually get the automatic tracking system scores of 50 to 60 or above that. It is important and it is crucial. Use simple formatting. Use bullet points. Match job description keywords. Use standard sections, headings, and use chronological or hybrid resume format. The things that you have done in recently, write them first, then write in the order, along with save in ATS friendly like formats like in docs. We are recommending you that you have to save your file in not the PDF format or not in PPT format. You just save the file in the .docs format. If they have the specific format, save it on that, but it is preferred to use the docs format for better ATS friendly. So the things I'm going to discuss in the details that you have to write in the resumes. So avoid complex layout. Use simple structure with clearly defined sections. Like you have to define the sections, which sections come first and which sections come at the end. Only if you writing the experience, then only writing about the experience. If you writing about the education, then in along with write about the education. Don't overlap any of the one with other. Use standard fonts like Times New Roman and Arial. These are the standard fonts you have to use in your resumes. No graphics or images. Images you can use is your college or not your images. You can definitely ignore your images in your resumes. You can use your college image along with the resume format, like some of the resumes are there that uses images. I think that's are not good. don't stick, don't paste your images over there. If you are using an institute image or any other image, that is fine, but don't use your images or anything else. Use bullet points that would make a positive impression for easy reading. If you're writing things in the bullet point that make it easy for the interviewer to see the things and understand in a very short manner. If you're writing in the bullet points, the ATS is easy for the ATS to see over there and think that what processing over there and match it with the description of the job given in to them. Job match description keyword. So this is very important. Firstly, you have to think about what are the job that you are applying for. Learn. Firstly, read the descriptions. Watch are the things and skills they are going through. What are the things they are demanding? Then make your resume according to that. Make the changes over there in your resumes. Be specific instead general terms like proficient in technology. Use exact words like JavaScript, AWS, search engine optimization. Use straight words. Don't use fancy words. Be specific. Use standard sections heading. Stick to common headings like work experience, education, skills and certification. These are the standard one that you have to use in your resume. Avoid creative headings that might confuse ATS, like my journey, what I have done. So use chronological or hybrid resume format that I have discussed. Use your recent experience in the first priority. Then write it over there according to the time. Save in ATS friendly format like in the docs format I have told you over there. Now let's move for the practical. So first we are going to make a practical resume in the Canva. Then we are making a resume in the Overleaf. So the Overleaf student can skip this part. So we are coming in the just 2 to 3 minutes and make a resume in the Canva. So this is Canva. You can log in it. You can go to canva.com and you can write simply resume in their search bar. Then you find a tons of resumes over there that you can use to make your resume. So I'm gonna selected the one. So I have selected previously the one that I have to edit. So this is the resume that I want to edit. I also give the description of this resume to you in the description. So here you can see it is very simple to add this resume. You have to click over there or hover over there and double click over there, and you can add the things like my name, my profession, like it is like process engineer, you can like software engineer or any other thing, marketing or any sales over there, sales executive and sales administrator over there. Along with you can write there your own address, your email, and if you have the website, then website over there. I think most of the student does not have the websites. So I simply cut over there. Then you can write your phone number over there. You can write your phone number like in the format of +91, then write your phone number. Along with you have to make a summary, the degree that you are pursuing or the job that you want according to their descriptions, job descriptions. Along with, if you don't have the professional experience, just write product over there. Don't think that we are a beginner, absolutely beginner, we don't get that job or that internship. Just write project over there and make your resume a short. You can think that you can make the skills like this making it long, resume making it for the 1/4 size sheet. So these are the things that you have to done to avoid the experience part. You can simply, if you don't have any experience, you can delete it over there, and you can add like project and the things that you can write along with the things like you have to write your skills that align with the job descriptions, and along with the things that are required in the Now let's move forward to the next section, that is the Overleaf one. So we're gonna take a sample resume and make a sample resume on the Overleaf platform. So this is the overleaf.com. This is the overleaf.com, and if you find the template option in your header part, then simply click on CV and resumes. Here you also find the tons of resumes that you can make with the Lattice language. So firstly, I selected this resume, then open as template, then I'm going to show you how to you can add this Lattice language template. So these are the things, these are the comments that is written over there, like title name. So you can add your name over there, like I am adding. Then you can recombine this. Recombine means you are compiling this code and the name is changing in the resume. So this is the standard one that you have to use. This is like something you write in the dme.md files, like this something. So this is the website where you can build your resume like that for the coding and for the bachelor degree. Especially these resumes are used for the programmers and the software engineers. So if you are applying for that jobs, you can use them. You can see this also have some relevant things that you want to write over there. So this is very simple. If you know about the HTML, you can simply add it over there. If you don't know about that, you can we have a description and there is a link of Word file you can add over there. Along with that's all for that video. I have show you the both the things, the Overleaf and the Canva. You can choose any one of them. If you making your resume the perfect one, then follow the ATS instruction, automatic tracking systems. Follow these guidelines only. I have researched them in the various websites, or you can say with the help of various things that my teachers told me, along with the HRs. I am talking to the many HRs that are in my contact. So that's all the things that we have to follow for a better resume, and I have summarized it in the one video. So you can share this video, like, share and subscribe to my channel. Thank you so much for